what sort of fishing can you expect out of Weymouth during the year then, Dave?
Well, I suppose if we start the year around January, January and February, March, the offshore pollock fishing can be quite good on the wrecks with big road up females, and there's still quite a few whiting and cod inshore, and that takes us into the early spring, March, April, May, where we get big place on the mussel beds and bream, the first run of bream down to the east. We go on then, we get some nice turbot on the bank, and that takes us into the summer species where we get tope and bullhurst congers and spur dog, bass, pollock, all inshore. And in June we get to run the first run of cod on the wrecks mid channel. They can last right through the summer, and it takes us full circle. We come to the autumn where we get a lot of bass inshore, especially when we have a good run of sprats. We have after October we get the first run of early whiting, and then we're back into the winter species again. So really the fishing out of Weymouth is 12 months. It's all obviously dependent on the weather, but it's the winter fishing can be extremely good.
Excellent. And what about catering for the anglers, individuals? Do you cater for them? Do you cater for groups, or how do you work?
Some skippers in the harbour cater mainly for individuals. That's the way they've set their business up. I do a few individual trips through the year because I get asked to do them, but I prefer to do group bookings. Most of my customers have become old friends, and we have a good laugh, like we have today. We have a good laugh and we pull each other's leg, and it just makes the day better for me with groups and rather than individuals. So most of my business is group bookings.
What about beginners? Do you cater for beginners?
Absolutely. I have a crewman with me all the time, Andy, and he's as good as gold. He's very, very patient with beginners, and he'll spend as much time as necessary showing them and coaxing them and explaining why we do things and how to do things and how we present baits. And we get lots of beginners come start with us and stay with us.
And what about if they haven't got all the tackle? Can you assist there?
Yeah, we have a policy of if anybody just needs a rod and reel, they're quite welcome to use our rods and reels free of charge. If anybody needs all of the tackle, that's the rod, the reel, all the leads and swivels and booms and all the rest of it, then we do make a charge, and that can be variable depending on what sort of trip we're doing. We don't tend to hire tackle for wreck fishing or for bass fishing, because it's a specialist kind of sport, and you really ought to be having your own gear by that time you've gone mid-channel wrecking or proper bass fishing. So most of our tackle hire is for inshore reef fishing for beginners.
Right. And what if you're really busy and you can't cater for crews or individuals? What would you recommend?
If someone rings me and I can't cater for them, I'll always pass them on to another skipper in the port.
Right.
We're lucky in Weymouth that most of the skippers work together. Most of us are friends with each other, and we tend to pass special individuals from one to another. So if I can't make it, I'll ring one of the other skippers, Colin Penny or Paul Davies, or someone that I know probably will have an individual place. And if I can't get them on the phone, I'll go to the Deep Sea website, where there is an individual search engine, which will show all of the boats that are available for a particular date for individuals or whole boat bookings.
And that's the deepsea.co.uk site, is it?
www.deepsea.co.uk.
Excellent. Well, thanks for that information. Just a quick look at those electronics that I can see on your
on the dashboard
position. What do they sort of provide?
These can be switched to any mode that I want, whether it's radar, sonar or plotter. This one at the moment is running in plotter mode. This one's on sonar mode, although the sonar transducer is switched off because we're at rest. I can get radar overlay on this as well. I can have that switch to radar, that can overlay on top of there. They're both interconnected to the AIS unit, that's the automatic identification system, and it will show me any AIS targets that we have within range. So if I zoom right in here, you'll see all these triangles are all ships. They're actually transmitting an AIS signal, so I can see where they are and who they are. And that's the same with that unit over there. That's a much bigger plotter, which is powered by its own little mini computer. It's very similar to the Raymarine one. If I zoom in, we should also see the same AIS targets on there. And there they are in the dark grey,
right,
the triangles.
Right.
And on top of all that, we've got three radios, VHF radios, a handheld, which has a built-in GPS unit and digital selective calling. And both of those radios are DSC, digital selective calling radios. This is a standalone GPS display unit. And that's the throttles and the autopilot, and then all the switches and paraphernalia that goes with it.
And you've got all the safety equipment on board as well, so.
Yes, we have all the we have to have all the safety equipment, otherwise we just don't pass the test, if you like. We have a self-inflating life raft on the roof. We have life buoys on the roof, and we have sufficient self-inflating life jackets for all of our passengers plus 10% standby.
Excellent. So all in all, you can provide quite a good day's fishing like we've just seen.
Well, we can't guarantee fishing, that is not the nature of the game. Fish will only feed when they want to, but we will guarantee that we will always try our best to put you on the fish and to help you catch them.
Excellent, thanks for all that information, Dave.
You're welcome.